mamas, I'm Shen and welcome back to my channel at Mama Banana. Today I have a cool hack for you. I'm going to show you a 5 minute craft on how you can turn these plain sit ball bags like this into a freestanding pouch like this. These are great to use around the house for organising toys, toiletries, cosmetics, and the great thing about them is that they're waterproof and they're also essentially stain resistant, so you don't need to worry about them getting grubby. If you would like to see more videos like this, please do subscribe to my channel. I'd really appreciate that, and be sure to hit the like button below. And without further ado, let's go straight into the tutorial. Okay, so starting off, you're going to want to grab yourself something to form the creases with. So what I have is just a toddler spoon. It just needs to be hard, firm and smooth so that it doesn't damage the bag. Okay, so starting off with the bag open, I am going to tuck these ends from the outside in. And then I'm going to do the same on the other side. At this point, you're going to be wanting to think what you're going to use this bag for so that you can determine how wide you want the base to be. And then you're going to put your thumbs into either side at the bottom and tuck it in like this, so it goes inside out. And then you're going to go inside and push on the bag back out. Okay, so I think that's about as wide as I'd want my base to be. Yeah. And the good thing about these bags is that they are mesh lined on the inside, so you can follow these lines. So now that I have it tucked in, I'm going to make sure that they're even by looking at these lines along the edge here. Yeah, that is straight. So I'm going to press down with my fingers. Turn around the other side. Pull, just to make sure that the material is taut and straight. Okay. And then I'm going to find that line again to make sure it's straight. And then press down with my fingers. Okay. That looks straight and even. I'm happy to form my crease here. So I'm going to get the back of the spoon and then press down along the edge. Just run the spoon all along. Flip around, do the same on the other side. Okay, and now I am going to grab the inside here. I call it a duckbill. That's the excess fabric on the inside. Grab that and push it down just to form a little tab. Again, using the mesh on the as a guide, make sure this is fully straight. And then fold it over into itself halfway to make sure it is even both sides. It's not really on the left is slightly longer. Push that back out. And that I can tell is perfect because the lines, the mesh lines here, is perfectly straight. So now I'm going to do the same on the other side. Okay. This will obviously be much quicker and easier to do when you're not angling it for the camera. And you can have it right under your nose to look properly at what you're doing. Okay. Now I'm just going to pull this over to make sure it's the same length. No, it's not. This is a bit longer, so I just need to push out a bit more material so that this is going to be a bit thinner. That seems about right now. So fold it over again, double check. Yeah, they are the same length. So now I can press down with my creaser. I'm calling this my creaser because I'm using it to form a hard crease. Flip it over. You want this crease to be quite prominent because it will help your pouch keep its shape. Do is I'm going to stick my finger into the tab here, pull down so that this will tuck in on itself, and then again using the mesh on the bags as a guide, find the line at the edge and press down, and then same on the other side, find the line on the edge, press down, do the same on the opposite side. Hold it flat on itself, pressing down on the two sides, and now use a creaser and go along those lines now. Now I only use a creaser up to about 2/3 of the way because I find if you have a hard crease all the way up to the zip, it's just not as smooth when you're opening up the bag. It doesn't affect the functionality of the bag, but it's just better if the hard crease doesn't go all the way up. And flip it over, do the creasing. Okay, so now your bag is pretty much done. What I'm doing is I'm just putting my hand inside the bag, pushing back out and creating that duck bill again with the excess material. So I'll show you what I'm calling a duck bill. It's this tab there on the inside of the bag. I'm calling that duck bill. I'm just making sure that is properly formed and then pressing it down flat into the base of the bag. I'll show you now. So you can see that tab is down at the base. Just freshen up this piece here. And now your bag is done. And you can use this to store anything you want. I just find it so handy for all the different toy sets we have around the house. And then if you want to pre-make a few of these can be stored flat again. So if you just put your fingers into the tabs at the bottom there and you pull to either side, so that you have the bottom of the bag inside, pull it flat, zip it up, and it can be stored flat again until you need to use it as a pouch, and you just do what I did there and push the base back out flat. Very quick and easy. Boom. I hope you will be trying out this hack. If you do, please leave me a comment below and let me know what you plan to use them for. I'd love to hear from you. I hope you enjoyed this hack today. If you did, I'd really appreciate it if you'd hit the subscribe button below so you can see more videos like this. I need to hit 1,000 fans before I can monetize this channel, so your support will be greatly appreciated. I upload 2 videos every week. I upload a video on hacks and tips for organizing around the house, and I also upload videos on products that I feel will help our lives as parents be a little bit easier and make organizing more fun. So until the next video, I'll see you and goodbye.